But before we begin what's going to be a very, very exciting program tonight, I would like you all to bow your heads for a minute, and we'd like to have a little moment of silence for one of our own, Will Fulford, as well as all friends and family that we have lost this past year. Thank you very much. It's with great pleasure to begin the program, and it's also with great pleasure that we have one of Maine's and New England's best sports directors, and that's Dave Eve from WGME-CBS. Dave is the sports director at WGME. He's a very loyal member of Red Sox Nation, but today, Dave is a member of Nor'easter Nation. So without further ado, our national ceremonies, Dave Eve.
Thank you so much. That was a warm welcome, and I got to tell you, this is a phenomenal 5 years now, and I've seen UNE grow into an absolute powerhouse, and I mean that very sincerely. The games that I covered this year, one night was the teddy bear toss night. I never saw anything like that in all my years. My camera was actually shaking after the Nor'easter scored against Kobe. So it's a great atmosphere. And the one thing I think that separates UNE from a lot of schools is the school spirit that you have here. And I see it every time I come up here. I see a lot of smiles from the student athletes. And that's something that you just don't see everywhere nowadays. So hats off to all of you and the staff and the administration. This is just a wonderful, wonderful place. And it's right here in Biddeford. It's unbelievable. So thank you again for having me. You guys probably don't really think about this, but you got to extend your high school career by another 4 years. And not every athlete can do that. To play high school sports is a great thing, but a lot of times that's the end of the road for athletes. So you get to do it at a phenomenal university with great fan support, great coaches, and state-of-the-art venues. So that is an awesome, awesome thing that you get to continue to fight. But without further ado, we are going to start our program today, and we are going to recognize the men's cross-country team first. In the men's cross-country team led by Ryan Ouellette, the Nor'easters won a pair of meets, including the UNE Invitational. They also placed fourth out of nine teams at the CCC Invitational. At this time, I'd like to ask Coach Ouellette to present the team's Coaches Award.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'll take a break before studying for your final exams. We all have a preconceived idea what Coaches Award recipients are all about. We've been giving these out for a number of years, and we hear the same things over and over again. Danny epitomizes all of these characteristics. Danny served as co-captain of the team, and reliability was the best adjective that describes him, whether it was planning preseason activities, whether asking him, Danny, to go down and get one of the bands and bring it back for practice at Rotary Park. And it gives me great pleasure this year for the Men's Cross Country Coaches Award, Danny White.
Alright, Coach, don't go too far. Next up, we have the women's cross-country team. The Nor'easters continue to establish themselves as one of the premier programs in New England, capturing their fifth consecutive conference title, guided by Conference Coach of the Year, Ron Ouellette. The team had the Conference Runner of the Year in Tiana Thomas, the Rookie of the Year in Mandy Graham, and the Senior Scholar Athlete of the Year in Brittany Sovello. Coach Ouellette will now present the team's Coaches Award winner.
Taking me up here and making Dave one little error. The runner of the year this year was Emma Robida, finishing first in the conference championship. Despite all her academic and athletic accolades, all conference, runner of the year, all conference, all academic team, New England All-Academic team. Emma played another important role in this team. Organizing, again, preseason is a big deal for us. Great opportunity for team bonding, getting those activities done. Emma was always the one initiating apparel orders for the team during that time period. An outstanding student athlete. This year's recipient is Emma Robodeau.
Now we're going to move on to field hockey. We'd like to honor the field hockey team, which won a school record 20 games and finished the season ranked 19th in the nation for the third consecutive year. CCC Coach of the Year, Danielle Collins, led the Nor'easters to a conference title in the second round of the NCAA Championship. The Nor'easters swept the CCC postseason awards with Nicole Matrazzo being selected Offensive Player of the Year, Holly Smith, Defensive Player of the Year, Bridget Kavanaugh, Rookie of the Year, and Desiree LeBlanc, the Senior Scholar Athlete of the Year. Matrazzo Smith, Wandy Saunders were also named All-Americans. I'd like to now ask Assistant Coach Molly Saunders to present the Field Hockey Team's Coaches Award winner.
You could always count on her to immediately do anything she was asked of, and this was never went unnoticed by the coaches. A hard worker, both on and off the field, this year's Field Hockey Coaches Award is being presented to Abby Willard.
Team. Under the direction of head coach Casey Keenan, the Nor'easters had five top-ranking finishes and were one of four qualifiers for the CCC Championship. Let's have Coach Keenan come up to present the golf team's Coaches Award.
I'd like to start by saying that today I'm representing all of us short people. It's really tough always being with that man. Finished his career as number two in the program history for individual scoring. He had his best individual season as a senior. He's been a very important piece, program success of the last 4 years. He also leads the program as number three on matches played, trailing just by one match fellow senior Ryan Mahoney and last year's senior captain Paul Buckovich. He holds four of the top 12 single-day low rounds in the history of the program, which is also second all-time for our team. On and off the golf course, he's been a great representative of our golf team, the program's core values, and the UNE community as a whole. Watching him grow into a mature young adult and welcome all the added responsibilities as a team leader has been a true pleasure. I need to personally say thank you to his family, especially his parents, who have been big supporters of the program, myself, and all of Sam's teammates. I will personally miss his commitment to me and the team. I know he's going to be very successful in all that he does as he leads UNE. 2017 Golf Team Coaches Award goes to senior Sam Knessler.
The 2016-17 academic year was the first for the women's rugby team as a varsity program, guided by Ashley Cotton-Fulford. The Nor'easters posted a 5-3 record in their fall season and recently competed their spring season for the title of the May Cup. Two players were chosen All-Americans, the sophomore Zoe Adams and Caitlin Paradis. At this time, I'd like to ask ask Coach Alfond Fulford to come forward to recognize the squad's Coaches Award winner.
The one thing that truly sets this player apart on our team is her ability to not only accept difficult roles, but her ability to adapt and be successful in each role that we've asked of her. This year, we asked her to lead us. Last year, we relied on her to defend for us. The year before that, we asked her to be our playmaker. And the year before that, we asked her to throw on an oversized rugby jersey, score some points after about 5 days of practice. Through all of this, this player has never questioned or wavered and has always displayed the one characteristic that is valuable no matter which sport it is that you're playing, a team-first attitude. I am so happy to award this year's Coach's Award for Women's Rugby to our senior captain, Katie Bornflow.
The next team we will be honoring is the men's soccer team, coached by Peter Ostergaard, the Nor'easters captain, CCC Senior Star Athlete of the Year, and Eric Holmquist, and also earned a win over St. Joe's College, just one of two losses for the Monks, who advanced to the second round of the NCAA Championship. I'd like to ask Coach Ostergaard to come up and present their Coaches Award winner.
The men's Coaches Soccer Award goes to Ryan Steven, a.k.a. Tiago. Please come down here. Tiago is the first player I've coached here for a full 4 years since joining UNE. We both have the same bumpy record. Tiago is a four-year starter, team captain, and has been instrumental to the program, especially the last 2 years, in many fronts. So we now stand with a very young and promising team. He's also developed a great understanding of the game, tactically. He's almost there. That being said, since I am not going to be at the senior brunch due to the men's trip to Morocco, I got to do a little drilling here, Tiago. When I first met Tiago, he was a very well-groomed, skinny kid who was more into how he looked than how he played. He's got a severe allergy towards weights, and he believes stretching is a waste of time. And the worst thing is that even though he's graduating, there's still going to be hanging a 20-inch picture outside my office with him on it. Besides that, I'm very proud that he's developed into a very mature young man both off and on the field. And to be completely honest, I'm not sure I had anything to do with it, but I like to think so.
And now we have the women's soccer team, led by Heather Davis. The Nor'easters posted a 9-6-2 record and were 5-2-2 in conference play. One of the individual highlights for the squad was midfielder Taylor Littlefield, linebacker, being voted CCC Senior Star Athlete of the Year. Would Coach Davis please come up to honor our team's Coaches Award winner?
Thank you. So it's a commonly accepted notion that with team sports, quite often the collective sum and the success of the group is much more than the individual pieces of talent that the players bring to the table. And I've been very blessed to see this in action over my time here at UNE, coaching a number of fabulous young women who are extremely talented and dedicated to their teammates. There's one young woman that's been a pleasure to coach who has taken this to another level. She didn't just add to the collective sum of the parts. With her loyalty and her attitude and her competitive spirit, but she amplified it and magnified it and took it to new heights. Sometimes the best things come to you in big surprises. This young woman didn't choose UNE initially, but I can't be more thankful that I had the opportunity that when she decided to change paths, she picked UNE and came here for her final 2 years. The UNE Women's Soccer Coaches Award goes to Devin Wolfenbach.
The next team this afternoon is the volleyball team. Coach Carol LaRue's team posted an 8-win improvement over the 2015 season and upset second-seeded Roger Williams in the opening round of the conference tournament. I'd like to ask Coach LaRue to please come forward and present her team's award.
As Coach Willette said, every coach has kind of an idea of what they really think deserves, who really deserves to be given the Coach of the Award. I think I keep three things very clear when I first meet my student athletes, and three categories that I always continue to tell them is I look for academic, athletic excellence, and community service, and not afraid to give back, and putting your team first, and less than one and three, but they kind of go together. This year's Coach's Award goes to someone who has all those three things. Academically, she's been a 4-year starting member of the volleyball team, and actually I met this young lady through orientation. She was taller than me, and I said, you know what, she must be a volleyball player. Chased her around, asked her if she played volleyball, she indicated yes, and she indicated she wasn't quite sure if she could do that at a college campus or here at UNE because of her emphasis on academics. Good thing she played. She's got her starting position at the end of her first year, and she was a force to be recognized with and never looked back. She has gained all of her academic and athletic accolades by pure determination and hard work. In the team, she's first in kills with 216 serving percentage. When in high school, didn't get to do this very often, but she has served at 93%. She totaled 232 points by herself. She's involved in so much community service. I'm not gonna go there because I've been on a limited time, but we'll be hearing a lot about this young lady at the senior brunch. But academically, I think it's to take note, she's a dual major in ocean studies and marine affairs and environmental science with a minor in philosophy, if that's not enough, with a GPA of 3.96. Erica Sorge, you have done it all, and it is my pleasure to present to you this year's 2007 Volleyball Coaches Award.
December road win over Keene State, which ended up advancing to the NCAA Elite 8 before losing to eventual champ Babson. Let's have Coach Silva come up to present his team's award.
So, in my mind, this is the most prestigious athletic award we can give out. Coming from the coaches, previous coaches that had stated kind of what this award meant to them. And I agree with everything they said. And our recipient this year, I think, embodies everything that I would hope for an athlete that came through our program to embody. You know, starting out from when he came into our program and honestly didn't get on the court at all other than warm-ups, to finishing out his career as a 3-year starter for us, and a huge, huge contributor to some big moments over the last few years in our program. His sophomore year, he was a part of one of the most memorable plays in our program, a game winner to upset the number one seed in the tournament. And his junior year, went to the foul line and knocked down 6 or 7 free throws at the end to upset the number two seed. And just in general, his daily grind and his effort and intensity is really something to be commended. So this year, the 2017 Men's Basketball Coaches Award, which is really like a career award from my perspective, is CJ Autry.
All right, next up is the the women's basketball team, guided by Conference Coach of the Year Anthony Ewing. The Nor'easters continued their dominance of the Commonwealth Coast Conference, winning their fifth consecutive title. Individually, Alicia Brown was voted State of Maine Player of the Year, while Sadie Nelson, a young lady who I covered in high school, was named Rookie of the Year. Let's have Coach Ewing present his team's award.
Each year, the women's basketball program gives out the Heather White Award, which is designed to go to the person who best exemplifies the best of what we want our program to be. And I had a lot of great candidates again this year. It makes it hard. But the winner is somebody who exemplifies exactly what we want our program to be about. Leadership, comes to practice literally every day to work extremely hard. Sweetest kid you'll ever meet, but tough as nails. One example I'll give is not this past year, the year before, she got smacked in the face square with an elbow. And she comes out, and I didn't see the wreckage, but she comes, she taps me on the shoulder. A few minutes later, I turn around, and there she is, half of her face just swollen, her teeth all jacked up. Her lip is so fat and split and held together with some butterfly stitches. And she said, "I'm good to go, coach." I said, "Sit down, Sam. We don't need you today." But she brings that attitude literally every day to practice as well. She plays hurt, not injured. And I'm just extremely thankful that she's in my program. This year's Heather White Award goes to Samantha McDonald.
Now, we'd like to present the men's ice hockey team, coached by Kevin Swallow. For the second consecutive season, the Nor'easters established a school record for wins on their way to the final game of the conference championship. A number of players garnered individual recognition, highlighted by first-team All-American Brady Farnham being named Conference Player of the Year, and first-year Ryan Bloom being chosen National Rookie of the Year. In addition, senior Trevor Florida earned 13 All-American status. At this time, I would like to ask Coach Swallow and to present his team's Coaches Award.
The Men's Hockey Coaches Award is voted on by our team. It's awarded to the player who best represents our program both on and off the ice. This year's recipient was our all-time leader in goals, assists, and points. He was named First Team All-Conference, All-New England, and an All-American. Senior Captain, Trevor Flora.
Next up is the women's ice hockey team, led by head coach David Venditti. The Nor'easters totaled 11 victories and won a New England Hockey Conference opening round playoff game for the second straight season. Let's have Coach Venditti come up to the stage and present his team's Coaches Award.
Thank you, Dave. Our Coaches Award, we actually call it the UNE way. And it's going to go to a person who I feel has been one of the hardest working players I've ever coached in my 27 years. Every practice, every game, she comes and gives 100% to the program. She's kind of an energy person during practice, keeping people going, being loud on the ice. As a coach, we hope that we teach our players. I can say that this player taught me to acknowledge when you make a mistake, to understand that you made a mistake and correct it, and I'm glad I corrected that mistake. This award goes to number 8, Mary White.
This afternoon is women's swimming, coached by Rick Hayes. His team posted a 7-2 mark in dual meets and placed 5th out of 21 teams at the New England Swimming and Diving Championships. Lindsay Thompson and Kayla Burgess each earned All-American status in three different events at the championship. Let's have Coach Hayes come forward to present the Coach's Award for Women's Swimming.
Good afternoon. When my assistant coach and I sat down to discuss the Coach's Award, this being our second season here, we decided to name this award the Maurister Award going forward. Annually, it will be presented to someone that buys into the coaching and team philosophy year to year, as well as the overall program goals. It will go to somebody that's a hardworking member of the team, both in the classroom and in the pool, and a respected leader, regardless of their title. They'll be an excellent representative of the team internally with teammates, coaches, and staff, and within the UNE Athletics and UNE community in general. They'll be an example of our philosophy, our approach, and mentality. This year's recipient is being recognized for their sportsmanship, their value to the program overall. She holds herself in a very high standard. This year's recipient has worked extremely hard over the last 2 years to get better and better, culminating with this year's New England's finish with two top eight performances, a school record in the 400 freestyle relay, and let's not forget, she set a school record here at UNE. This year's recipient is Eleni Boggs.
Under the leadership of Conference Coach of the Year, Charlie Birch, the men's lacrosse team had its most successful season on record, tying a school record with 14 wins and finishing third in the conference standings for the first time. The Nor'easters nearly swept the conference major awards, with Dan Osher being named Offensive Player of the Year and Senior Scholar Athlete of the Year David Pearson as the Defensive Player of the Year, and Adam Rice winning the Rookie of the Year award. I'd like to ask Coach Birch to come forward for his team's award.
This year's award winner for our team not only was a great captain and leader for us off and on the field this past year, really throughout his career, represented the program very well all 4 years he's been here, but also took the lead on our spring charity games, reaching the last 3 years, starting when he was a sophomore, was we raised money for the Wounded Warrior Project. Junior year, when we raised money for Play for the Cure and lymphoma research. And this past spring, when we raised money again for the National Fallen Firefighters Association. David Pearson's our award winner.
Coached by Sue Estabrook. Like the men, the women advanced to the semifinals of the conference tournament for the second consecutive year. They reached double digits in wins once again and had the conference Senior Star Athlete of the Year in Jocelyn Davey. Would Coach Estabrook please come forward to present the team's coaches award?
This year's award goes to a truly inspiring fight to me as a coach and to all of our teammates. After training her ACL twice, after the third being sophomore and junior year, she was unanimously voted captain by her teammates, staying truly engaged. She's a terrific leader, and if she chooses to return next year, I'm certainly delighted. Casey would be seen.
And now to conclude our recognition of the Coaches Award winners is the softball team. Coached by Dan Letellier, the Nor'easters posted their 13th consecutive season with a record of 500 or better, winning a total of 15 games. Sydney Helmbrecht was voted Conference Senior Scholar Athlete of the Year, giving the athletics department a total of 7 winners of this prestigious award. Please welcome Coach Letellier.
All right, thank you very much for taking time out of the studies today to join us. The Coaches Awards, you know, every year is somebody that's just a tremendous player, a representative of the program, and somebody that, you know, does everything above and beyond what any coach can ever ask for. Just a little bit defensively on this one player, you know, just speaking with Tristan earlier, you know, she has not made an error in the last 86 games of her career, and also did not make an error in over 165 occurrences. So she's just a, you know, she's a leader on the field, she's a leader off the field. Unfortunately, she can't be here today due to a death in the family, and I was just texting her saying, hey, you got a second to FaceTime? She goes, shucks, I'm bored and coach. But the Coach's Award for the softball team goes to Sydney Helmbrecht.
All right, the next part of our program is new to this event. We will be recognizing the top students in the areas of athletic training, strength and conditioning, and in club and intramural sports. At this time, I'd like to introduce athletic trainer Jasmine Honey to present the Athletic Training Students of the Year. Jasmine presents remarks.
All right, I'm here to present awards to the male and female athletic training students of the year. These two individuals exemplify all of the qualities that we expect from our athletic training students. Their dedication to the program and the teams they worked with was unwavering, and their passion for the profession is astounding. I am thankful to have had the opportunity to work with both of them, and I am very excited to see where their careers take them in the future. Congratulations to Emily Zocco and Sam Magdott.
Next up is strength and conditioning coordinator, Lindy Kelly.
Hi guys. So first off, I'd like to start by recognizing my Norris strength and conditioning interns. So, will all of you please stand? Lenny, Sam, Brooke, Shannon, Nick, Tori, and Lindy. So I'm here to present the Royster Strength and Conditioning Team of the Year Award. We award one each year to the women and men's team that most exemplify what we call Royster Grit, which I hope you all know what I know. But it's greatness, resilience, integrity, and tenacity. So the teams that show those four traits in the weight room and on the court and field ice every single day are the teams that were awarded this award every year. This year's recipients really took it to a whole other level. They had an incredible level of electricity in the weight room, and we like our puns in the weight room, right, Brooke? Every single time they came in, they changed the entire atmosphere of the entire weight room. You know, whether it was saving me from a life, you know, it was a life situation here, life and death situation with a giant fish in Florida, or it was being part of the
Thank you.
And now I'd like to ask Assistant Director of Athletics, Patty Williams, to come forward to present the awards for the club and intramural sports.
Hey everybody, I took over the club sports program this year, my first year doing it after Carol LaRue did it for a very long time. And today I'm going to recognize our club sport of the year. So we actually have 13 club sports, for those of you who don't know, and over 240 athletes that participate. Our club sport of the year is given out annually and is voted on by all the clubs and given out at our club sports award ceremony. This year's recipient is the Gymnastics Club. Here are some of the results from this past year. At the MIT meet, Jenna finished third on the beam, Amanda finished third on vault and third all around, and they finished fourth place for the team. At their home meet at UNE, Maddie finished first place all around and finished first place team. And at Nationals, Jenna finished seventh place beam, Amanda sixth place bars, ninth place floor, fifth all around, Maddie first place beam, eighth place all around, and they finished fourth place team. Also at Nationals, Amanda received the 2017 Female Athlete of the Year Award, which is a very prestigious award given out by the NAGC. Congratulations to the Gymnastics Club on winning the 2017 Club Sport of the Year.
Before we honor the major award winners for the 2016-2017 academic year, we would like to take a moment to recognize the large number of student athletes who have distinguished themselves in the classroom. Listed in today's program are the honorees for the Chi Alpha Sigma and the UNE All-Academic Team. Chi Alpha Sigma is a national student athlete honor society and recognizes juniors and seniors with a cumulative grade point average of 3.40 or higher. The UNE All-Academic Team includes nearly 150 sophomores, juniors, and seniors with a GPA of 3.30 and higher. I'd also like to ask all members of the Chi Alpha Sigma and the UNE All-Academic Team to please stand and be recognized. And now for the presentation of the department's major awards for 2016-2017. Nominations were made by the head coaches, and the voting was done by the entire athletics department staff. The first major award we're going to present this afternoon is the Female Rookie of the Year. This year we have co-recipients. The first winner played a pivotal role in the field hockey team, winning its third consecutive conference championship. As a defensive player, she scored 5 goals and had 1 assist to finish with 11 points. A starter in all 24 of the team's matches, she was voted Commonwealth Coast Conference Rookie of the Year. This year's co-recipient of UNE Female Rookie of the Year Award winner is Bridget Kavanaugh. The other winner of the award was a standout for the women's basketball team, which captured its 5th straight conference title. She was 2nd on the team in scoring, averaging 10 points a game, and was in the top 3 in rebounds, assists, and steals. A 2nd team all-conference pick, she was voted State of Maine Rookie of the Year. Let's have a round of applause for Sadie Nelson. The male Rookie of the Year contributed significantly to the success of the men's ice hockey team. As a first year, he led the nation in points per game among rookies at 1.65 per game with 20 goals and 23 assists. He was voted National Rookie of the Year and 2nd Team All-Conference. This year's UNE Male Rookie of the Year winner is Ryan Bloom. The Female Athlete of the Year was one of the driving forces behind the field hockey team's record-breaking season. She totaled 49 points to become the program's career leader with 126. This young woman garnered a slew of awards, including Conference Offensive Player of the Year, First Team All-Conference, First Team All-Region, and Second Team All-America. The 2016-2017 UNE Female Athlete of the Year is Nicole Matrazzo. The Male Athlete of the Year had the most accomplished season a men's lacrosse player at UNE has ever had. He scored 42 goals and had 51 assists to break a UNE single season mark for points and establish a career record in that category with 260. He was voted Conference Offensive Player of the Year and Conference Senior Scholar Athlete of the Year. A 2-time UNE Athlete of the Month, this year's Male Athlete of the Year is Dan Osher.
Let's give a big round of applause to JV for a great job of your turn. And while we're giving out some thank yous, as you all know, we're only good as our teammates. And my teammates today, Kurt, Joan, Tristan, Cynthia, the facility people, the Sodexo people, let's also give them a great round of applause for a great night. In addition to that, I do want to thank, and we would not have the facility and facilities and great teams and coaches, but I do want her last year, she couldn't be here, but President Rippich and Provost Jim Coble for all their tremendous support, for all they do for not only athletics, but for the whole campus. So, quickly. As you know, we've experienced another incredible year, and I just would like to list some quick facts. We had 329 wins, 145 losses, and 10 ties for a 70% winning percentage. Numerous coaches of the year, the 2nd most athletes in the conference for scholar athletes, the 2nd most senior scholar, the most senior scholar athletes in the conference. 15 of our teams advanced to the playoffs. 10 of our teams advanced to the conference final four. Four teams advanced to their conference championship game. Three teams, basketball, cross country, and field hockey, won their conference tournaments. And four teams advanced to the NCAA and the national tournament. What you did this year on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. It really was something special. And it was so fun to turn on the computer every day and see something on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, or on the website about something good that you have done on or off the field. It really was very gratifying. And like my senior administrative team, we couldn't be where we all are today without our excellent head coaches. Let's give them a huge round of applause. Lastly, I think the thing you saw the video earlier, is what you do in the community. And to see the smiles on children, to see the smiles on senior citizens, to see the smiles of people in the hospital, the money that you've raised, and just the smiles that you gave to people, and including your own smiles, I couldn't be happier for what our Northeastern Neighbors did in the community. And I'm sorry if I repeat myself, but in sports, somebody wins and somebody loses. And in community service, everybody wins. So thank you very much. And before we start the video, I'm a big Steve Jobs fan. One of his most famous lines at the end of the convention, he would always say, "And one more thing." And what I'd like to do now, and I know she's going to be really ticked off at me, but Joan Howard, can you come up here, please? She's all pissed off at me.
We are
UNE.
We are
UNE.